السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم. There are many aspects with regard to Ramadan. Undoubtedly, it is a month of discipline, a month of inculcating taqwa through the means of fasting, as Allah says in the Holy Quran. It is also a month in which we turn towards Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in ibadat and tilawat, zikr and salat, etc. However, our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in a very famous hadith, had said, "Huwa shahrul muwasat." One of the fundamental objectives of Ramadan is it is a month of kindness and compassion. Now, obviously, kindness and compassion is something that is required in every month. Why did our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Ramadan is a month in which you inculcate kindness and compassion? The ulama have written, amongst other reasons, one is when you are eating 3 square meals a day, and especially people who are, Allah Ta'ala has given them wealth, etc., and they are having a comfortable style of living, then it's sometimes difficult to inculcate kindness and compassion to the less privileged when you are privileged. And in Ramadan, when we do bear the pangs of hunger and we do bear the pangs of our thirst, then kindness and compassion comes more readily than when you are eating 3 square meals a day. That is why Nabi Karim Sallam said, it is a month of kindness and compassion. And it reminds me of a statement that is attributed to Maria Antoinette during the time of the French Revolution. Very famous statement. When she was told that the common people do not have bread to eat, then she said, if they don't have bread, let them eat cake. Now that comes when you are having 3 square meals a day, you find it difficult to inculcate kindness and compassion. But when you are going through Ramadan and you are going through fast, then kindness comes more readily. And kindness is that quality which is associated with Allah. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam told Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha once, O Aisha, be kind, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves kindness, and He gives for kindness what He does not give for harshness or anything else. And in one hadith, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, which I will conclude today's small lesson, إِذَا أَرَادَ بِأَهْلِ بَيْتٍ خَيْرٌ أَدَخَلَ عَلَيْهِمُ الرِّفْقُ. When Allah wants goodness in a home, He introduces kindness in that home. When you want to know whether your home has Allah's rahmat, then see how your interaction is with people. If it is based on kindness, it means Allah Ta'ala's rahmat is upon that home. So let us make this Ramadan a month in which we inculcate kindness.